watch Paul Ryan on the campaign trail and you begin to notice a constant companion, a 40-something pound bag he lugs around himself.
I'm probably seen with it all the time.
A weighty burden he clearly can't live without.
Can you show us?
Well, sure. I mean, it's just...
I could barely lift it.
I gotta put my leg down so I can... It's a little heavy. I don't know. What do you think? It's about 30, 40 pounds.
At least. Is this the keys to the kingdom right there?
Inside, weeks of piled-up prep for tonight's debate.
It's pretty heavy. I've got a lot of binders, different subjects. I'm much more successful if I do things properly and prepare. Social Security, Medicaid, and Medicare.
Talk to anyone who knows Paul Ryan, and one word always comes up to describe him: prepared. Older brother Tobin Ryan.
This is a guy that does more in a day, absorbs more in a day than I think is humanly possible.
I've always disbelieved in if you're going to do something, do it well. And life is short. You've got to make the most of it.
Seize the moment. A lesson a teenage Paul Ryan learned from tragedy, his father's untimely death at age 55.
This is the house where Paul Ryan was raised, and at age 16, it's where he found his father in bed, dead from a heart attack. It's a moment that he says forced him to grow up very fast at a young age.
Tobin Ryan remembers the transformation.
One of his legacies was to think big. I want to stretch your mind. You need to absorb. And so Paul grew up, I think, in an environment where if you made a comment, you know, our dad would say, why do you say that? Have you thought about, enough of it? Are you thinking big enough?
In his small hometown of Janesville, Wisconsin, Ryan always thought big. In high school, he was in 10 clubs, was prom king, and class president.
But he also was voted biggest brown noser. Why do you think that is?
He must have been the biggest brown noser.
In Washington, after college, the ambitious young Ryan made a point of forging relationships with powerful GOP players. Former Housing Secretary and Vice Presidential candidate Jack Kemp. Former Education Secretary Bill Bennett.
Paul's Paul.
Yeah.
But
back in Wisconsin, Ryan sought out local GOP guru Steve King, who agreed to give a 27-year-old Ryan his first break, backing him for Congress over several more experienced Republican candidates.
Two were frankly not happy with me, and one was a part of a close personal friend who maybe today isn't a close personal friend.
I'm guessing you don't regret that decision.
No, not at all. He has this youthful appearance to him, and yet, as one of my friends, a Democrat actually, told me, he said, he's got an old soul. He gets it.
But he also had an advantage in this part of Wisconsin others didn't, the Ryan name. Paul Ryan's uncle started Ryan Inc., a highly successful dirt moving company. Ryan's father was a prominent Janesville lawyer. Until he died, his name was on this law firm that towers over downtown. Ryan's first congressional campaign was a family affair.
Nice to meet you.
His siblings and extended family pitched in.
My wife, our little baby, my mother. We thought we were doing some fun volunteer work for our brother. Lo and behold, it was 8 months, 90 hours a week.
At age 28, Ryan won his first House race and was reelected 6 times since.
What do you think your dad would say or think about the fact that his youngest son is the vice presidential candidate?
Of course, my dad would be immensely proud.
Proud, perhaps, that his son took his advice to think big.
What I learned at a young age is if you get involved, you can make a difference in this country. That's what's so great about this country.